The following is a free for download audiobook from the website KrishnaPath.org. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Part 1, Chapter 3, Gajendra's Prayers of Surrender. In this chapter, the prayers of Gajendra, the king of the elephants, are described. It appears that the king of the elephants was formerly a human being, known as Indradumna, and that he learned a prayer to the Supreme Lord. Fortunately, he remembered that prayer and began to chant it to himself. First, he offered his respectful obeisances to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and because of his awkward position in having been attacked by the crocodile, he expressed his inability to recite prayers nicely. Nonetheless, he tried to chant the mantra and expressed himself in appropriate words as follows. Quote, "The Supreme Personality of Godhead is the cause of all causes, the original person from whom everything has emanated. He is the root cause of this cosmic manifestation, and the entire cosmos rests in him. Yet he is transcendental, for he does everything in relation to the material world through his external energy. He is eternally situated in the spiritual world in Vaikuntha or Goloka Vrindavan, where he engages in his eternal pastimes. The material world is a product of his external energy, or material energy, which works under his direction. It is thus that creation, maintenance, and annihilation take place. The Lord exists at all times. This is extremely difficult for a non-devotee to understand. Although the transcendental Supreme Personality of Godhead is perceivable by everyone, only the pure devotees perceive his presence and activities. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is completely free from material birth, death, old age, and disease. Indeed, if anyone in this material world takes shelter of him, he also becomes situated in that transcendental position. For the satisfaction of the devotee, Pratyanaya Sadhanam, the Lord appears and exhibits his activities. His appearance, disappearance, and other pastimes are not at all material. One who knows the secret can enter into the kingdom of God. In the Lord, all opposing elements are adjusted. The Lord is situated in everyone's heart. He is the controller of everything. He is the witness of all activities, and he is the original source of all living entities. Indeed, all living entities are parts and parcels of him, for he is the original origin of Mahavishnu, who is the source of the living entities within this material world. The Lord can observe the activities of our senses, which can work and achieve material results because of his mercy. Although he is the original source of everything, he is untouched by any of his byproducts. In this way, he is like a gold mine, which is the source of gold and ornaments, and yet is different from the ornaments themselves. The Lord is worshipped by the method prescribed in the Pancharatras. He is the source of our knowledge, and he can give us liberation. Therefore, it is our duty to understand him according to the instructions of devotees, in particular, the spiritual master. Although for us, the mode of goodness is covered, by following the instructions of saintly persons and the spiritual master, we can be free from material clutches. The self-effulgent material form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is adored by non-devotees, his impersonal form is adored by those advanced in spiritual knowledge, and his feature as the localized supersoul is appreciated by yogis. But his original form as person is understood only by devotees. That Supreme Personality of Godhead is competent to dissipate the darkness of the conditioned soul through his instructions in Bhagavad Gita. He is the ocean of transcendental qualities and can be understood only by liberated persons freed from the bodily concept of life. By his causeless mercy, the Lord can rescue the conditioned soul from the material clutches and enable him to return home back to Godhead to become his personal associate. Nonetheless, a pure devotee does not aspire to go back to Godhead. He is simply satisfied with executing his service in this material world. A pure devotee does not ask anything from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. His only prayer is to be free from the material conception of life and to be engaged in the Lord's transcendental loving service." End quote. In this way, the king of the elephants, Gajendra, offered prayers directly to the Supreme Personality of Godhead without mistaking him for one of the demigods. None of the demigods came to see him, not even Brahma or Shiva. Rather, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayan, seated on Garuda, personally appeared before him. Gajendra, by lifting his trunk, offered obeisances to the Lord, and the Lord immediately pulled him from the water along with the crocodile who had captured his leg. Then the Lord killed the crocodile and thus released Gajendra. Text 1. Sri Shukadeva Goswami continued, Thereafter, the king of the elephants, Gajendra, fixed his mind in his heart with perfect intelligence and chanted a mantra which he had learned in his previous birth as Indradyumna and which he remembered by the grace of Krishna. Purport. Such remembrance is described in Bhagavad Gita 6:43 and 44. Tatra tam buddhi samyogam labdheye parvadehikam yatate chatato buya simsado kurunandana purva basena taneva riyanti hi aviso pisa. In these verses, it is assured that even if a person engaged in devotional service falls down, he is not degraded, but is placed in a position which he will, in due course of time, remember the Supreme Personality of Godhead. As explained later, Gajendra was formerly King Indradyumna, and somehow or other, in his next life, he became King of the Elephants. Now Gajendra was in danger, and although he was in the body other than that of a human being, he remembered the stotra he had chanted in his previous life. Yatate chatato buya samsido kurunandana. To enable one to achieve perfection, Krishna gives one the chance to remember him again. This is proved here, for although the king of the elephants, Gajendra, was put in danger, this was a chance for him to remember his previous devotional activities so that he could immediately be rescued by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is imperative, therefore, that all devotees in Krishna consciousness practice chanting some mantra. Certainly, one should chant the Hare Krishna mantra, which is the Maha mantra, or great mantra, and also one should practice chanting Chintamani Prakashadmashu or the Nishinga Stotra, Ito Nishingo Parato Nishingo Yato Yato Tato Nishingo. Every devotee should practice in order to chant some mantra perfectly so that even though he may be imperfect in spiritual consciousness in this life, in his next life he will not forget Krishna consciousness even if he becomes an animal. Of course, a devotee should try to perfect his Krishna consciousness in this life, for simply by understanding Krishna and his instructions, after giving up this body, one can return home back to Godhead. Even if there is some fall down, practice of Krishna consciousness never goes in vain. For example, Ajamil in his boyhood practiced chanting the name of Narayan under the direction of his father, but later in his youth he fell down and became a drunkard, woman hunter, rogue, and thief. Nonetheless, because of chanting the name of Narayan for the purpose of calling his son, who he had named Narayan, he became advanced, even though he was involved in sinful activities. Therefore, we should not forget the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra under any circumstances. It will help us in the greatest danger, as we find in the life of Gajendra. Text 2. The king of the elephants, Gajendra, said, I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Supreme Person, Vasudeva. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Because of him, this material body acts due to the presence of spirit, and he is therefore the root cause of everyone. He is worshipable for such exalted persons as Brahma and Shiva, and he has entered the heart of every living being. Let me meditate upon him. Purport. In this verse, the words Echatachidatmakam are very important. The material body certainly consists only of material elements, but when one awakens to Krishna conscious understanding, the body is no longer material, but spiritual. The material body is meant for sense enjoyment, whereas the spiritual body engages in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. Therefore, a devotee who engages in the service of the Supreme Lord and who constantly thinks of him should never be considered to have a material body. It is therefore enjoined, Gurushu Naramati. One should stop thinking of the spiritual master as an ordinary human being with a material body. Archie Vishnu Shiladi. Everyone knows that the deity in the temple is made of stone, but to think that the deity is merely stone is an offense. Similarly, to think that the body of the spiritual master consists of material ingredients is offensive. Atheists think that devotees foolishly worship a stone statue as God and an ordinary man as the guru. The fact is, however, that by the grace of Krishna's omnipotence, the so-called stone statue of the deity is directly the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and the body of the spiritual master is directly spiritual. A pure devotee who is engaged in unalloyed devotional service should be understood to be situated on the transcendental platform. Sagunan samatityaitan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. Let us therefore offer our obeisances unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by whose mercy so-called material things become spiritual when they're engaged in spiritual activity. Omkar, Pranava, is the symbolic and sound representation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Om Tat Sat Iti Nirdesho Brahmanas Trivida Smrita. The three words Om Tat Sat immediately invoke the Supreme Person. Therefore, Krishna says that he is Omkar in all the Vedic mantras, Pranava Sarva Vedeshu. The Vedic mantras are pronounced beginning with Omkar to indicate immediately the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Srimad Bhagavatam, for example, begins with the words Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. There is no difference between the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudev, and Omkar, Pranav. We should be careful to understand that Omkar does not indicate anything nirakara or formless. Indeed, this verse immediately says Om Namo Bhagavate. Bhagavan is a person. Thus, Omkar is the representation of the Supreme Person. Omkar is not meant to be impersonal, as the Mayavadi philosophers consider it to be. This is distinctly expressed here by the words Purushaya. The supreme truth addressed by Omkar is Purusha, the supreme person. He's not impersonal. Unless he's a person, how can he control the great stalwart controllers of this universe? Lord Vishnu, Lord Brahma, and Lord Shiva are the supreme controllers of this universe, but Lord Vishnu is offered obeisances even by Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma. Therefore, this verse uses the word parashaya, which indicates that the Supreme Personality of God is worshipped by exalted demigods. Parashaya means Parameshwara. Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva are Ishwara's great controllers, but Lord Vishnu is Parameshwar, the supreme controller. Text 3. The Supreme Godhead is the supreme platform on which everything rests, the ingredient by which everything has been produced, and the person who has created and is the only cause of this cosmic manifestation. Nonetheless, he is different from the cause and the result. I surrender unto him, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is self-sufficient in everything. Purport. In Bhagavad Gita 9.4, the Lord says, Mayam tatamidam sarvam jagat avyakti murtina. Quote, I am the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but everything rests upon my energy, just as an earthen pot rests on the earth. End quote. The place where an earthen pot rests is also earth. Then again, the earthen pot is manufactured by a potter whose body is a product of earth. The potter's wheel with which the pot is made is an expansion of earth, and the ingredients from which the pot are made are also earth. As confirmed in the Shruti mantra, Yatova imani bhutani jayanti yena jitani jivanti yat prayanti abhisambhishanti. The original cause of everything is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and after being annihilated, everything enters into him. Praktim yanti mamikam. Thus, the Supreme Lord, the Personality of Godhead, Lord Ramchandra, Lord Krishna, is the original cause of everything. Ishvara Paramakrishna, Satchitananda Vigraha, Nadigadi Govinda, Sarvakarna Karnam. Quote, Krishna, who is known as Govinda, is the Supreme Controller. He has an eternal, blissful, spiritual body. He is the origin of all. He has no other origin, for he is the prime cause of all causes. End quote. Brahma Samhita 5.1. The Lord is the cause for everything, but there is no cause for him. Sarvamikala vibham brahma. Matstani sarvabhutani nachaham tvaisravashtita. Although he is everything, his personality is different from the cosmic manifestation. Text 4. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, by expanding his own energy, keeps this cosmic manifestation visible and again sometimes renders it invisible. He is both the supreme cause and the supreme result, the observer and the witness, in all circumstances. Thus, he is transcendental to everything. May that Supreme Personality of Godhead give me protection. Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead has multipotencies, prashishakti vividayashuyati. Therefore, as soon as he likes, he uses one of his potencies, and by that expansion, he creates this cosmic manifestation. Again, when the cosmic manifestation is annihilated, it rests in him. Nonetheless, he is infallibly the supreme observer. Under any circumstances, the Supreme Lord is changeless. He is simply a witness and is aloof from all creation and annihilation. Text 5. In due course of time, when all the causative and effective manifestations of the universe, including the planets and their directors and maintainers, are annihilated, there is a situation of dense darkness. Above this darkness, however, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I take shelter of his lotus feet. Purport. From the Vedic mantras, we understand that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is above everything. He is supreme above all the demigods, including Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva. He is the supreme controller. When everything disappears by the influence of his energy, the cosmic situation is one of dense darkness. The Supreme Lord, however, is the sunshine, as confirmed in the Vedic mantras. Aditya Varnam Tamasa Parashtat. In our daily experience, when we are on Earth or in the darkness of night, the sun is always luminous somewhere in the sky. Similarly, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Supreme Sun, always remains luminous, even when the entire cosmic manifestation is annihilated in due course of time. Text 6. An artist on stage being covered by attractive dresses and dancing with different movements is not understood by his audience. Similarly, the activities and features of the supreme artist cannot be understood even by the demigods or great sages, and certainly not by those who are unintelligent like animals. Neither the demigods and sages nor the unintelligent can understand the features of the Lord, nor can they express in words his actual position. May that Supreme Personality of Godhead give me protection. Purport. A similar understanding was expressed by Kunti Devi. The Supreme Lord exists everywhere, within and without. He even exists within the heart. Shrivasya chaham hridi sannivisto. Ishara sarvabuddhanam hridi shurjanatistati. Thus, it is indicated that one can find the Supreme Lord within one's heart. There are many, many yogis trying to find him. Dhyana vashita tadgatena manasa prashyanti yam yogina. Nonetheless, even great yogis, demigods, saints, and sages have been unable to understand the bodily features of that great artist, nor could they understand the meaning of his movements. What then is to be said of ordinary speculators like the so-called philosophers of this material world? For them, he is impossible to understand. Therefore, we must accept the statements given by the Supreme when he kindly incarnates to instruct us. We must simply accept the word of Lord Ramchandra, Lord Krishna, and Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and follow in their footsteps. Then it may be possible for us to know the purpose of their incarnations. Janma karma chamedivyam yevam yogadi tatvatatok tadeham parnarjamani naitimamiti sarjana. Bhagavad Gita 4:9. If, by the Lord's grace, one can understand him, one will immediately be delivered, even within his material body. The material body will no longer have any function, and whatever activities take place within the body, with the body, will be activities of Krishna consciousness. In this way, one may give up his body and return home, back to Godhead. Text 7. Renunciates and great sages who see all living beings equally, who are friendly to everyone, and who flawlessly practice in the forest the vows of brahmacharya, vanaprastha, and sannyas, desire to see the all-auspicious lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. May that Supreme Personality of Godhead be my destination. Purport. This verse describes the qualifications for devotees or persons highly elevated in spiritual consciousness. Devotees are always equal to everyone, seeing no distinction between higher and lower classes. Pandita Samadarshana, they look upon everyone as a spirit soul who is part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. Thus, they are competent to search for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Understanding that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the friend of everyone, Suridam Sarvabhutanam, they act as friends of everyone on behalf of the Supreme Lord. They make no distinction between one nation and another one, or one community and another. They preach Krishna consciousness, the teachings of Bhagavad Gita, everywhere. Thus, they are competent to see the lotus feet of the Lord. Such preachers in Krishna consciousness are called Paramahansas. As indicated by the word Vimukta Sangha, they have nothing to do with the material conditions. One must take shelter of such a devotee in order to see the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Texts 9 and 10. The Supreme Personality of Godhead has no material birth, activities, name, form, qualities, or faults. To fulfill the purpose for which this material world is created and destroyed, he comes in the form of a human being, like Lord Ram or Lord Krishna, by his original internal potency. He has immense potency, and in various forms, all free from material contamination, he acts wonderfully, and he is therefore the Supreme Brahman. I offer my respects to him. Purport. In the Vishnu Purana, it is said, Gunams cha dosams cha mune vyatita samashta kalyana gunatmako hi. The Supreme Personality of Godhead has no material form, qualities, or faults. He is spiritual and is the only reservoir of all spiritual qualities. As stated in Bhagavad Gita 4.8 by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Pritinaya Sadhanam Vinas Chaduskritam, the Lord's activities of saving the devotees and annihilating the demons are transcendental. Anyone annihilated by the Supreme Personality of Godhead gets the same result as a devotee who is protected by the Lord. Both of them are transcendentally promoted. The only difference is that a devotee goes directly to the spiritual planets and becomes an associate of the Supreme Lord, whereas demons are promoted to Brahmaloka, the impersonal effulgence of the Lord. Both of them, however, are transcendentally promoted. The Lord's killing or annihilating of the demons is not exactly like the killing of this material world. Although he appears to act within the modes of material nature, he is nirguna, above the modes of nature. His name is not material, otherwise how could one get liberation by chanting Hare Krishna Hare Rama? The names of Lord like Rama and Krishna are non-different from the person Rama and Krishna. Thus, by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, one constantly associates with Rama and Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and therefore becomes liberated. The practical example is Ajamil, who always remained transcendental to his activities simply by chanting the name Narayan. If this was true of Ajamil, what is to be said of the Supreme Lord? When the Lord comes to this material world, he does not become a product of matter. This is confirmed throughout Bhagavad Gita. Janma karma chamedavimayavamayavare tatvatat avananjananti mamudha manasim tamamashritam. Therefore, when the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Ram or Krishna, descends to act transcendentally for our benefit, we should not consider him an ordinary human being. When the Lord comes, he does so on the basis of his spiritual potency. Sambhavami atmamayaya. Because he's not forced to come by the material energy, he's always transcendental. One should not consider the Supreme Lord an ordinary human being. Material names and forms are contaminated, but spiritual name and spiritual form are transcendental. Text 10. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the self-effulgent Supersoul, who is the witness in everyone's heart, who enlightens the individual soul, and who cannot be reached by exercises of the mind, words, or consciousness. Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, cannot be understood by the individual soul through mental, physical, or intellectual exercises. It is by the grace of the Supreme Personality of Godhead but that the living individual soul is enlightened. Therefore, the Lord is described here as Atma Pradipa. The Lord is like the sun, which illuminates everything, and cannot be illuminated by anyone. Therefore, if one is serious about understanding the Supreme, one must receive enlightenment from him. As instructed in Bhagavad Gita, one cannot understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead by one's mental, physical, or intellectual powers. Text 11. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is realized by pure devotees who act in the transcendental existence of Bhakti Yoga. He is the bestower of uncontaminated happiness and is the master of the transcendental world. I therefore offer my respect to him. Purport. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, the Supreme Personality of Godhead can be understood only by devotional service. Bhakti mama bijananti yavanyas chasmi tatvata. If one wants to know the Supreme Personality of Godhead in truth, one must take to the activities of devotional service. These activities are called sattva or shuddha sattva. In the material world, activities of goodness, which are symptomatic of a pure brahmana, are appreciated, but the activities of devotional service are shuddha sattva. In other words, they are on the transcendental platform. Only by devotional service can one understand the Supreme. Devotional service is called naishkarmya. Mere negation of material activity will not endure. Naishkarmyam apijachuti bhava varjitam. Unless one performs activities with reference to Krishna consciousness, cessation of material activities will not be helpful. In hopes of achieving naishkarmya, freedom from material action, many highly elevated sannyasis stopped their activities, yet they failed and returned to the material platform to act as materialistic persons. But once one is engaged in the spiritual activities of bhakti yoga, one does not fall down. Our Krishna consciousness movement is therefore an attempt to engage everyone always in spiritual activity, by which one becomes transcendental to material actions. The spiritual activities of bhakti marga, shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu, smaranam, padasevanam lead one to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, as stated here, sattvena pratila bhaya naishkarmyena vipaschita. Quote, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is realized by pure devotees who act in the transcendental existence of bhakti yoga, end quote. And the Gopalatapani Upanishad 15 says, bhaktir asya bhajanam tad iha mutropadi nayasyenaiv vamusmin manasya kalpanam etad eva cha naiskarmyam. This is a definition of naiskarmya. If one acts in naiskarmya, when he fully engages in Krishna conscious activities without material desires to enjoy, either here or in the upper planetary systems, in the present or in a future life, iha amurta, anyabilashita sunyam, when one is free from all contamination, he acts in devotional service under the direction of the spiritual master, one is on the platform of naishkarma. By such transcendental devotional service, the Lord is served. I offer my respectful obeisances unto him. Text 12. I offer my respectful obeisances unto Lord Vasudev, who is all-pervading, to the Lord's fierce form as Lord Nrsingadev, to the Lord's form as an animal, Lord Varahadev, to Lord Dattatreya, who preached impersonalism, to Lord Buddha, and to all the other incarnations. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Lord, who has no material qualities, but who accepts the three qualities of goodness, passion, and ignorance within this material world. I also offer my respectful obeisances unto the impersonal Brahman effulgence. Purport. In the previous verses, it has been described that although the Supreme Personality of Godhead has no material form, he accepts innumerable forms to favor his devotees and kill the demons. As stated in Srimad Bhagavatam, there are so many incarnations of the Supreme Personality of Godhead that they are like the waves of a river. The waves of a river flow incessantly, and no one can count how many waves there are. Similarly, no one can calculate when and how the different incarnations of the Lord appear according to the necessities of time, place, and candidates. The Lord appears perpetually, as Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita 4:7, Yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavita bharata abhutanam dharmasya tadatmanam shujamyaham. Whenever and wherever there is decline in religious practice, O descendant of Bharat, and a predominant rise of irreligion, at that time I descend myself, end quote. In the material world, there is always the possibility of deviation from Krishna consciousness, and therefore Krishna and his devotees always act in various forms to curb such godlessness. Even impersonalists who stress the knowledge feature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead want to merge in the effulgence of the Lord. Therefore, here the word jnana-ganaya indicates that for atheists who disbelieve in the form and existence of the Lord, all the various incarnations appear. Since the Lord comes to teach in so many forms, no one can say there is no God. The word jnana-ganaya is specially used here to refer to those whose knowledge has become solidified by dint of their searching for the Lord through speculative philosophical understanding. Superficial knowledge is useless for understanding the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but when one's knowledge becomes extremely intense and deep, one understands Vasudeva, Vasudeva Sarvameti Samahatma Sadurlabha. A jnani attains this stage after many, many births. Therefore, the words jnana-ganaya is used here. The word santaya indicate that Lord Vasudeva is situated in everyone's heart, but does not act with the living entity. Impersonalist jnanis realize Vasudeva when they are fully mature in knowledge. Vasudeva sabhameti samatma sadurlabha. Text 13. I beg to offer my respectful obeisances unto you, who are the Supersoul, the superintendent of everything, and the witness of all that occurs. You are the Supreme Person, the origin of material nature and the total material energy. You are also the owner of the material body. Therefore, you are the supreme complete. Offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. In Bhagavad Gita 13.3, the Lord says, Cheta Gyan Chapiman Vidi Sarva Chetu Shibharata. Quote, O sign of Bharat, you should understand that I am also the knower in all bodies. End quote. Every one of us is thinking, quote, I am this body, or, quote, this is my body, end quote. But actually, the truth is different. Our bodies are given to us by the Supreme Proprietor. The living entity, who is also Chetragna, or the knower of the body, is not the body's only proprietor. The actual proprietor is the body of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the Supreme Chetragna. For example, we may rent and occupy a house, but actually the owner of the house is the landlord. Similarly, we may be allotted a certain type of body as a facility with which to enjoy this material world, but the actual proprietor of the body is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is called Sarvadhyaksha because everything in the material world works under his supervision. This is confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 9.10, wherein the Lord says, My dakshina prakriti suite sacharacharam. Quote, this material nature working under my direction, O son of Kunti, is producing all moving and unmoving beings, end quote. From prakriti, or material nature, come so many varieties of living entities, including aquatics, plants, trees, insects, birds, animals, human beings, and demigods. Prakriti is the mother, and the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the father. Aham bija pradapita. Prakriti can give us material bodies, but as spirit souls, we are parts and parcels of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 15.7. Mamaivam so jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana. The living entity being part and parcel of God is not a product of this material world. Therefore, the Lord is described in this verse as Atma Mula, the original source of everything. He is the seed of all existences. Bijam mam sarvabhutanam. In Bhagavad Gita 14.4, the Lord says, Sarvyonisha kontiya mortiya sambhavantiya tasham brahma mahadyonir aham bijapadavita. It should be understood that all living entities and all species of life, O son of Kunti, are made possible by birth in this material nature, and that I am the seed-giving father. End quote. Plants, trees, insects, aquatics, demigods, birds, beasts, and all other living entities are sons or parts and parcels of the Supreme Lord, but because they are struggling with different mentalities, they have been given different types of bodies, mana shastriyandriyani prakritistani karshati. Thus, they have become sons of prakriti, or material nature, which is impregnated by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Every living entity in this material world is struggling for existence, and the only salvation or relief from the cycle of birth and death in the evolutionary process is full surrender. This is indicated by the word nama, quote, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, end quote. Text 14. My Lord, you are the observer of all the objectives of the senses. Without your mercy, there is no possibility of solving the problem of doubts. The material world is just like a shadow resembling you. Indeed, you accept this material world as real. One accepts this material world as real because it gives a glimpse of your existence. Purport. To paraphrase this verse, quote, the objectives of sensual activities are actually observed by you. Without your direction, the living entity cannot even take a step forward. As confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 15.15, Sarvasya Cham Riti Sanavistoma Tismati Garamapuanam Cha. You are situated in everyone's heart, and only from you come remembrance and forgetfulness. Chayeva Yasya Brahmani Bibharti Durga. The living entity under the clutches of Maya wants to enjoy this material world, but unless you give him directions and remind him, he cannot make progress in pursuing his shadowy objective in life. The conditioned soul wrongly progresses toward the Ram objective life after life, and he's reminded of that objective by you. In one life, the conditioned soul desires to progress toward a certain objective, but after his body changes, he forgets everything. Nonetheless, my Lord, because he wanted to enjoy something of this world, you reminded him of this in his next birth. Matasmiti gyanam apuanam cha. Because the conditioned soul wants to forget you, by your grace, you give him opportunities life after life by which he can almost perpetually forget you. Therefore, you are eternally the director of the conditioned souls. It is because you are the original cause of everything that everything appears real. The ultimate reality is your lordship, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. End quote. The word Sarva Pratyaya Hetave is explained by Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur, who says that the result gives one a glimpse of its cause. For example, since an earthen pot is the result of the actions of a potter, by seeing the earthen pot, one can guess at the existence of the potter. Similarly, this material world resembles the spiritual world, and any intelligent person can guess how it is acting. As explained in Bhagavad Gita, Maya Dakshina Prakriti Sute Chasracharam. The activities in the material world suggest that behind them is the superintendence of the Lord. Text 15. My Lord, you are the cause of all causes, but you yourself have no cause. Therefore, you are the wonderful cause of everything. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, who are the shelter of Vedic knowledge contained in the Shastras, like the Pancharatras and Vedanta Sutra, which are your representations, and who are the source of the Parampara system. Because it is you who can give liberation, you are the only shelter for all transcendentalists. Let me offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is described herein as the wonderful cause. He is wonderful in the sense that although there may be unlimited emanations from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Jamadhyasyayata, he always remains complete, Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vishishite. In our experience in the material world, if we have a bank balance of $1 million, if we withdraw money from the balance gradually diminishes until it becomes nil. However, the Supreme Lord, the Personality of Godhead, is so complete that although innumerable personalities of Godhead expand from him, he remains the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, Parashisha Purnasya Purnam Adaya Purnam Eva Vashishite. Therefore, he is the wonderful cause. Govindamadi Purusham Tamham Jami. Ishvara Paramakrishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadiyadi Govinda Sarvakarna Karnam. Quote, Krishna, who is known as Govinda, is the Supreme Controller. He has an eternal, blissful, spiritual body. He is the origin of all. He has no other origin, for he is the prime cause of all causes. End quote. Brahma Samhita 5.1. Even in this material world, we can understand that the sun has existed for millions of years and has given off heat and light since its creation, yet the sun still retains its power and never changes. What, then, is to be said of the supreme cause, Parabrahma, Krishna? Everything emanates from him perpetually, yet he maintains his original form, Satchidananda Vigraha. Krishna personally says in Bhagavad Gita 10.8, Mata Sarvam Pravartate, quote, everything emanates from me, end quote. Everything emanates from Krishna eternally, yet he is the same Krishna and does not change. Therefore, he is the shelter of all transcendentalists who are eager to get free from material bondage. Everyone must take shelter of Krishna. It is therefore advised, Akama Sarvakama Va Moksha Kama Udaradi Tivrena Bhakti Yogena Tad Yajeta Purushamparam. Quote, whether one desires everything or nothing, or desires to merge into the existence of the Lord, he is intelligent only if he worships Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by rendering transcendental loving service. End quote. Srimad Bhagavatam 2.3.10. Param Brahma, the Supreme Lord, and Param Dhamma, the Supreme Repose, is Krishna. Therefore, anyone who desires anything, whether it be a karmi, a jnani, or a yogi, should try to perceive the Supreme Personality of Godhead very seriously, and all his desires will be fulfilled. The Lord says, Ye tam mam prapadyante tam shtavya bhajami aham. Quote, as the living entities surrender unto me, I reward them accordingly. End quote. Even the karmi who wants everything for his enjoyment can get it from Krishna. For Krishna, supplying what he wants is not at all difficult. Actually, however, one should worship Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, for the sake of getting liberation. Vedasya Savara Home Vivedya. By studying the Vedic literature, one should understand Krishna, as confirmed here. Sarva Gama Nayam Mahanarvaya. He is the ocean, and all Vedic knowledge flows toward him. Therefore, intelligent transcendentalists take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sarva Dharman Pratyaja Mamikam Sharanam Vaja. This is the ultimate goal. Text 16. My Lord, as the fire in irony wood is covered, you, by your unlimited knowledge, are covered by the material modes of nature. Your mind, however, is not attentive to the activities of the modes of nature. Those who are advanced in spiritual knowledge are not subject to the regulative principles directed in the Vedic literatures. Because such advanced souls are transcendental, you personally appear in their pure minds. Therefore, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. In Bhagavad Gita 10.11, it is said, Tesham evanu karm pantam aham ajnana tam tama nasa yami atma bhava sto jnana dipena bhashvata. For a devotee who has taken the lotus feet of the Lord within his heart, the Lord gives spiritual enlightenment known as jnana dipa by special mercy from within. This jnana dipa is compared to the fire hidden within irony wood. To perform fire sacrifices, great sages previously did not ignite a fire directly. The fire would be invoked from irony wood. Similarly, all living entities are covered by the modes of material nature, and the fire of knowledge can be ignited only by the Supreme Personality of Godhead when one takes him within one's heart. Sabai mana Krishna parada vindeo. When one takes seriously the lotus feet of Krishna, who is seated within one's heart, the Lord eradicates all ignorance. By the torch of knowledge, one immediately understands everything properly. By the special mercy of the Supreme Lord, and becomes self-realized. In other words, although a devotee may externally not be very well educated, because of his devotional service, the Supreme Personality of Godhead gives him enlightenment from within. If the Lord gives enlightenment from within, how can one be in ignorance? Therefore, the allegation of the Mayavadis that the devotional path is for the unintelligent or uneducated is untrue. Yasyati bhaktir bhagavati akinchana savaskunas tatra samastate sura. Srimad Bhagavatam 5.18.12. If one becomes an unalloyed devotee of the Supreme Lord, he automatically manifests all good qualities. Such a devotee is above the instructions of the Vedas. He is a Paramahansa. Even without going through the Vedic literature, a devotee becomes pure and enlightened by the mercy of the Lord. Quote, therefore, my Lord, end quote, the devotee says, quote, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, end quote. Text 17. Since an animal such as I has surrendered unto you, who are supremely liberated, certainly you will release me from this dangerous position. Indeed, you are extremely merciful. You incessantly try to deliver me. By your partial feature as Paramatma, you are situated in the hearts of all embodied beings. You are celebrated as direct transcendental knowledge, and you are unlimited. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Purport. The words Brihate Namaste have been explained by Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. Brihate Shri Krishnaya, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is Krishna. There are many tattvas such as Vishnu Tattva, Jiva Tattva, and Shakti Tattva, but above everything is the Vishnu Tattva, which is all-pervading. This all-pervading feature, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is explained in Bhagavad Gita 10.42, wherein the Lord says, Atava Bahuna Aitena Kim Yatena Tavarjuna Vishtabhayam Idam Kristam or Kristnam Ekam Sena Stito Jagat. Quote, what need is there, Arjuna, for all this detailed knowledge? With a single fragment of myself, I pervade and support this entire universe, end quote. Thus, Krishna says that the entire material world is maintained by his partial representation as Paramatma. The Lord enters every universe as Garbhadakshaya Vishnu and then expands himself as Chiradakshaya Vishnu to enter the hearts of all living entities and enter even the atoms. Adantarastu Paramano Chayantarastam. Every universe is full of atoms, and the Lord is not only within the universe but also within the atoms. Thus, when within every atom, the Supreme Lord exists in his Vishnu feature as Paramatma, but all the Vishnu tattvas emanate from Krishna, as confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 10.2, Aham Idar Hi Devanam. Krishna is the Adi, or beginning, of the Devas in this material world, Brahma, Vishnu, and Maheshwara. Therefore, he is described here as Bhagavate Brihat. Everyone is Bhagavan, Everyone possesses opulence, but Krishna is Brihan Bhagavan, the possessor of unlimited opulence. Ishvara Parama Krishna, Krishna is the origin of everyone. Aham Sarvasya Prabhava. Even Brahma, Vishnu, and Maheshwar come from Krishna. Mata Partanam Nanyat Kinshid Asti Dhananjaya. There is no personality superior to Krishna. Therefore, Vishnath Chakravarti Thakur says that Bhagavate Bharte means, quote, unto Sri Krishna, end quote. In this material world, everyone is a pashu, an animal, because of the bodily conception of life. Yasmatma buddhir kunapiti datuke svadi kalatradishu brahma ijayadi tatirta buddhe salalek nakarichit jagneshu arvigneshu saevagurkara. Quote, a human being who identifies the body made of three elements as the self, who considers the byproducts of the body to be his kinsmen, who considers the land of his birth to be worshipable, and who goes to a place of pilgrimage simply to take bath rather than to meet men of transcendental knowledge there, is to be considered like an ass or a cow. End quote. Srimad Bhagavatam 10.84.13. Practically everyone, therefore, is a pashu, or an animal, and everyone is attacked by the crocodile of material existence. Not only the king of the elephants, but every one of us is being attacked by the crocodile and is suffering the consequences. Only Krishna can deliver us from this material existence. Indeed, he is the always trying to deliver us. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hridayeshu arjuna tisthati. He is within our hearts and is not at all inattentive. His only aim is to deliver us from material life. It is not that he becomes attentive to us only when we offer our prayers to him. Even before we offer our prayers, he incessantly tries to deliver us. He is never lazy in regard to our deliverance. Therefore, this verse says, Buddhi karanaya namo lalaya. It is the causeless mercy of the Supreme Lord that he always tries to bring us back home, back to Godhead. God is liberated and he tries to make us liberated, but although he is constantly trying, we refuse to accept his instructions. Sarva dharman prachajam amikam sharanam bhaja. Nonetheless, he has not become angry. Therefore, he is described here as buddhi karunaya, unlimitedly merciful, in delivering us from this miserable material condition of life and taking us back home, back to Godhead. Text 18. My Lord, those who are completely free from material contamination always meditate upon you within the core of their hearts. You are extremely difficult to attain for those like me who are too attached to mental concoction, home, relatives, friends, money, servants, and assistants. You are the Supreme Personality of Godhead, uncontaminated by the modes of nature. You are the reservoir of all enlightenment, the Supreme Controller. I therefore offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Purport. Although the Supreme Personality of Godhead comes into the material world, he is unaffected by the modes of material nature. This is confirmed in Isha Upanishad. Apapa vidam. He is not contaminated. This same fact is described here. Guna sangha vivarjitaye. Although the Supreme Personality of Godhead appears as an incarnation within this material world, he is unaffected by the modes of material nature. As stated in Bhagavad Gita 9.11, Avajananti ma mudha manasim tanam ashritam. Foolish men with insufficient knowledge deride the personality of Godhead because he appears like a human being. Therefore, the Supreme Personality of Godhead can be understood only by the Muktatma, the liberated soul. Muktatma bi sva hridaye paribhavitaya. Only the liberated person can constantly think of Krishna. Such a person is the greatest of all yogis. Yoginam api sarve shamat katenadaratmana shradavan bhajate yumam same yuktatamo mata. Quote, of all yogis, he who always abides in me with great faith, worshipping me in transcendental loving service, is most intimately united with me in yoga and is the highest of all. End quote. Bhagavad Gita 6.47. Text 19. After worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead, those who are interested in the four principles of religion, economic development, sense gratification, and liberation obtain from him what they desire. What then is to be said of other benedictions? Indeed, sometimes the Lord gives a spiritual body to such ambitious worshippers. May that Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is unlimitedly merciful, bestow upon me the benediction of liberation from this present danger and from the materialistic way of life. Purport. Some men within this material world are akami, free from material desire. Some are ambitious to get more and more material profit, and some desire fulfillment in religious life, economic development, sense gratification, and finally liberation. Akama savakamo ba mokshakamo udaradi tivrena bhaktiyogena yajeta purushamparam, Srimad Bhagavatam 2.3.10. It is recommended that whatever one's position, whether one demands no material profit, all material profit, or ultimately liberation, one should offer his obedient devotional service to the Lord, and one will get what he desires. Krishna is so kind. Ye tamam prapadyante tam sudaiva bhajamyaham. The Lord reciprocates. Whatever even an ordinary living entity wants, Krishna gives. Krishna is situated in everyone's heart, and he gives that which is desired by the living entity. Ishvara sarva bhutanam ridyeshar janatisati brahmanyam sarva bhutani yanti rudrani maya. Quote, the Supreme Lord is situated in everyone's heart, O Arjuna, and is directing the wanderings of all living entities who are seated as on a machine made of the material energy, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 18.61. The Lord gives everyone an opportunity to fulfill his ambitions. Even such a devotee as Dhruva Maharaj wanted the material ambition of a kingdom greater than that of his father, and although he received a spiritual body, he also got the kingdom, for the Supreme Personality of Godhead does not disappoint anyone who takes shelter of his lotus feet. Therefore, since Gajendra, the king of the elephants, has surrendered to the Supreme Personality of Godhead to get free from the present danger and indirectly from the present danger of materialistic life, why should the Supreme Personality of Godhead not fulfill his desire? Texts 20 and 21. Unalloyed devotees who have no desire other than to serve the Lord, worship him in full surrender, and always hear and chant about his activities, which are most wonderful and auspicious. Thus, they always merge in an ocean of transcendental bliss. Such devotees never ask the Lord for any benediction. I, however, am in danger. I thus pray that the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is eternally existing, who is invisible, who is the Lord of all great personalities, such as Brahma, who is available only by transcendental bhakti yoga, being extremely subtle, he is beyond the reach of my senses and transcendental to all external realization. He is unlimited, and he is the original cause, and he is completely full of in everything. I offer my obeisances unto him. Purport. Anya bilashita sunyam jnanakarnamadi navritam anakilena krishnanu shilanam bhakti rutama bhakti darsamita sindhu 1111. Quote, one should render transcendental loving service to the Supreme Lord Krishna favorably, without desire for material profit or gain, through fruitive activities or philosophical speculation. That is called pure devotional service, end quote. Unalloyed devotees have nothing to ask from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but Gajendra, the king of the elephants, was circumstantially asking for immediate benediction because he had no other way to be rescued. Sometimes, when there is no alternative, a pure devotee, being fully dependent on the mercy of the Supreme Lord, prays for some benediction. But in such a prayer, there is also regret. One who always hears and chants about the transcendental pastimes of the Lord is always situated on a platform on which he has nothing to ask in terms of material benefits. Unless one is completely a pure devotee, one cannot enjoy the transcendental bliss derived from dancing and chanting in the ecstasy of the Sankirtan movement. Such ecstasy is not possible for an ordinary devotee. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu showed us how one can enjoy transcendental bliss simply by chanting, hearing, and dancing in ecstasy. This is bhakti yoga. Therefore, the king of the elephants, Gajendra, said, Adhyatmika yogam gamyam, indicating that unless one is situated on this transcendental platform, one cannot approach the Supreme Lord. The benediction of being able to approach the Lord can be achieved after many, many births. Yet, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has awarded this benediction to everyone, even the fallen souls who have no heritage of anything in spiritual life. That is actually being seen in the Krishna consciousness movement. Therefore, the path of bhakti yoga is the spotless process by which to approach the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Bhaktiham akeya griya. Only through devotional service can one approach the Supreme Lord. The Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 7.1, Mai ishtaka mana parta yogam yunjam mat ashraya. Asam sayam samangramam yata yasi chut trenu. Quote, now hear, O son of Prita, Arjuna, how by practicing yoga in full consciousness of me, with mind attached to me, you can know me in full, free from doubt, end quote. Simply by being attached to Krishna consciousness and by thinking of the lotus feet of Krishna constantly, one can fully understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead without a doubt. Texts 22 and 24. The Supreme Personality of Godhead creates his minor parts and parcels, the Jiva Atma, beginning with Lord Brahma, the demigods, and the expansions of Vedic knowledge, Sama, Rig, Yajur, and Atharva, and including all other living entities, moving and non-moving, with their different names and characteristics. As the sparks of a fire or the shining rays of the sun emanate from their source and merge into it again and again, the mind, intelligence, the senses, the gross and subtle material bodies, and the continuous transformations of the different modes of nature all emanate from the Lord and again merge into him. He is neither demigod nor demon, neither human nor bird nor beast. He is not man, woman, or neuter, nor is he an animal. He is not immaterial quality, a fruit of activity, a manifestation, or non-manifestation. He is the last word in the discrimination of, quote, not this, not this, end quote. And he is unlimited. All glories to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Purport. This is a summary description of the Supreme Personality of Godhead's unlimited potency. That Supreme One is acting in different phases by manifesting his parts and parcels, which are simultaneously differentially situated by his different potencies, Parsha Shakti Vivida Vishuyati. Each and every potency is acting quite naturally, Subhava Viki Ganabila Kriyacha. Therefore, the Lord is unlimited. Natasvamas Chebyadikas Chadrisyate. Nothing is equal to him, nor is anything greater than him. Although he manifests himself in so many ways, personally he has nothing to do. Natasya karam karanam nacha vidyate, for everything is done by expansions of his unlimited energies. Text 25. I do not wish to live anymore after I am released from the attack of the crocodile. What is the use of an elephant's body covered externally and internally by ignorance? I simply desire to eternal liberation from the covering of ignorance. That covering is not destroyed by the influence of time. Purport. In this material world, every living entity is covered by the darkness of ignorance. Therefore, the Vedas enjoin that one should approach the Supreme Lord through the spiritual master who is described and offered prayers in the Gautamiya Tantra as follows. Om Jnana Timinandasya Gananjana Shalakaya Chakshalamitamyena Tasmishi Gurave Namaha. Quote, I offer my respectful obeisances unto my spiritual master who, with the torchlight of knowledge, has opened my eyes which were blinded by the darkness of ignorance. End quote. Although one may struggle for existence in this material world, to live forever is impossible. One must understand, however, that this struggle for existence is due to ignorance, for otherwise every living being is an eternal part of the Supreme Lord. There is no need to live as an elephant or man, Indian or American. One should desire only to achieve liberation from the cycle of birth and death. Because of ignorance, we consider every life offered by nature to be happy and pleasing, but in the degraded life of within this material world, from the life of Brahma down to that of an ant, no one can actually be happy. We are making so many plans to live happily, but there cannot be any happiness in this material world, however we may try to make a perfect permanent settlement in this life or that. Text 26. Now, fully desiring release from material life, I offer my respectful obeisances unto that Supreme Person who is the creator of the universe, who is himself the form of the universe, and who is nonetheless transcendental to this cosmic manifestation. He is the supreme knower of everything in this world, the supersoul of the universe. He is the unborn, supremely situated Lord. I offer my respectful obeisances unto him. Purport. Sometimes, when Bhakti Yoga Krishna consciousness is preached to the common man, people argue, quote, where is Krishna? Where is God? Can you show him to us? End quote. In this verse, the answer is given that if we are sufficiently intelligent, we must know that there is someone who has created the entire cosmic manifestation, who has supplied and that has become the ingredients for this cosmic manifestation, who is eternally existing, but who is not within this cosmic manifestation. Simply on the basis of this suggestion, one can offer respectful obeisances unto the Supreme Lord. That is the beginning of the devotional life. Text 27. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Supreme, the Supersoul, the Master of all mystic yogi, who is seen in the yoga, who is seen in the core of the heart of perfect mystics when they are completely purified and free from the reactions of fruitive activity by practicing bhakti yoga. Purport. The king of the elephants, Gajendra, simply accepted that there must be someone who has created this cosmic manifestation and has supplied its ingredients. This should be admitted by everyone, even the most determined atheists. Why, then, do the non-devotees and atheists not admit this? The reason is that they are polluted by the reactions of their fruitive activities. One must be freed from all the dirt accumulated within the heart due to fruitive activities performed one after another. One must wash off this dirt by practicing bhakti yoga, yoga randita kramana. As long as one is covered by material nature's modes of ignorance and passion, there is no possibility of understanding the Supreme Lord. Tada rajas tamo bhava kamo labdas yachaye. When one is free from the modes of ignorance and passion, one becomes free from the lowest qualities, kama and loba, lust and greed. Nowadays, there are so many yoga schools to encourage people in developing their lusty desires and greed through the practice of yoga. People are therefore very much fond of so-called yoga practice. Actual practice of yoga, however, is described here. As authoritatively stated in Srimad Bhagavatam 12.13.1, Dhyana vasita tad gatena manasa pashyanti yam yogina. A yogi is one who always meditates on the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is also confirmed in the Brahma Samhita 5.38. Premanjana charita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hridyeshu vilokayanti yam shama sundara machintya guna sarupam govinda mari purusham tamham jami. I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, who is Shyamasundara, Krishna himself, with inconceivable, innumerable attributes, whom the pure devotees see in their heart of hearts with the eye of devotion tinged with the salve of love. End quote. The bhakti yogi constantly sees Shyamasundara, beautiful Lord Krishna, with his blackish bodily hue. Because the king of the elephant, Gajendra, thought himself an ordinary animal, he thought himself unfit to see the Lord. In his humility, he thought that he could not practice yoga. In other words, how can those who are like animals in the bodily concept of life and who have no purity of consciousness practice yoga? In the present day, people who have no control over their senses and who have no understanding of philosophy and who do not follow the regular religious principles or rules and regulations are nonetheless pretending to be yogis. This is the greatest anomaly in the practice of mystic yoga. Text 28. My Lord, you are the controller of formidable strength in three kinds of energy. You appear as the reservoir of all sense pleasure and the protector of the surrendered souls. You possess unlimited energy, but you are unapproachable by those who are unable to control their senses. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you again and again. Purport. Attachment, greed, and lust are three formidable forces that prevent one from concentrating upon the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. These forces act because the Supreme Lord does not like to be realized by non-devotees and atheists. However, when one surrenders unto the lotus feet of the Lord, these impediments are withdrawn and one can realize the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, the Lord is the protector of the surrendered soul. One cannot become a devotee until one surrenders unto the Lord's lotus feet. Then the Lord gives one the intelligence from within by which one can return home back to Godhead. Text 29. I offer my respectful obeisances unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, by whose illusory energy the jiva, who is part and parcel of God, forgets his real identity because of the bodily conception of life. I take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whose glories are difficult to understand. Purport. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, every living entity, regardless of whether he be human, demigod, animal, bird, bee, or whatever, is a part and parcel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Lord and the living entity are intimately related like father and son. Unfortunately, because of material contact, the living entity forgets this and wants to enjoy this material world independently according to his own plan. This illusion, Maya, is very difficult to surmount. Maya covers the living entity because of his willingness to forget the Supreme Personality of Godhead and make his own plans to enjoy this material world. As long as this contamination continues, the conditioned soul will be unable to understand his real identity and will perpetually continue under illusions life after life. Ato grihakshetra sutapa vater janasya maham aham yam aham ameti. Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.8. As long as the living entity is not enlightened so that he may understand its real position, he will be attracted to materialistic life, to house, country, or field, to society, sons, family, community, bank balance, and so on. Covered by all this, he will continue to think, quote, I am this body, and everything related to this body is mine, end quote. This materialistic conception of life is extremely difficult to surmount, but one who surrenders to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as did Gajendra, the king of the elephants, comes to enlightenment on the Brahman platform. Brahma Bhuta Prashanatma Nashochati Nakankshati Samasarvesha Bhuteshu Mad Bhakti Milabhate Param. Quote, one who is transcendentally situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed toward all living entities. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me. End quote. Bhagavad Gita 18.54. Since a devotee is completely on the Brahman platform, he is not jealous of any other living entity. Samasa Rusheu Bhuteshu. Text 30. Sri Shukadeva Goswami continued, when the king of the elephants was describing the supreme authority without mentioning any particular person, he did not invoke the demigods headed by Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Indra, or Chandra. None of them approached him. However, because Lord Hari is the supersoul, Purushottama, the personality of Godhead, he appeared before Gajendra. Purport. From the description of Gajendra, he apparently was aiming at the supreme authority, although he did not know who the supreme authority is. He conjectured, quote, there is a supreme authority who is above everything, end quote. Under the circumstances, the Lord's various expansions, such as Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Chandra, and Indra, all thought, quote, Gajendra is not asking for our help. He is asking for the help of the supreme, who is above all of us. End quote. As Gajendra has described, the Supreme Lord has various parts and parcels, including the demigods, human beings, and animals, all covered by separate forms. Although the demigods are in charge of maintaining different aspects of the universe, Gajendra thought that they were unable to rescue him. Harim bina naiva mritim taranti. No one can rescue anyone from the dangers of birth, death, old age, and disease. It is only the Supreme Personality of Godhead who can rescue one from the dangers of material existence. Therefore, an intelligent person to get free from this dangerous existence approaches the Supreme Personality of Godhead, not any demigod. As confirmed in Bhagavad Gita 7.20, kamastasta hritagyana prabhadyante devata. Those who are unintelligent approach the various demigods for temporary material benefits. Actually, however, these demigods cannot rescue the living entity from the dangers of material existence. Like other living entities, the demigods are merely external parts of the Supreme Personality of Godhead's transcendental body. As stated in the Vedic mantras, Sa Atma Agani Anya Devata. Within the body of the Atma, the soul, is the Atma, the soul, whereas the various parts of the body, like the hands and legs, are external. Similarly, the Atma of the entire cosmic manifestation is Narayan, Lord Vishnu, and all the demigods, human beings, and other living entities are parts of his body. It may be concluded also that since a tree lives on the strength of its root, and when the root is nourished with water, all the parts of the tree are nourished, one should worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the original root of everything. Although the Supreme Personality of Godhead is very difficult to approach, he is very near to us because he lives within our hearts. As soon as the Lord understands that one is seeking his favor by fully surrendering, he immediately takes action. Therefore, although the demigods did not come to the aid of Gajendra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead immediately appeared before him because of his fervent prayer. This does not mean that the demigods were angry with Gajendra, for actually when Lord Vishnu is worshipped, all the other demigods are also worshipped. Yasmin tu stejagat tustam. If the Supreme Personality of Godhead is satisfied, everyone is satisfied. Yata tarar mula nishan nisichanena tripyanti tat skanda bujo pakshaka prano pakra chach chayatendriyanam tataiva savarhanam uchayatya. Quote, as pouring water on the root of a tree energizes the trunk, branches, twigs, and everything else, and as supplying food to the stomach enlivens the senses and the limbs of the body, so simply worshiping the Supreme Personality of Godhead through devotional service automatically satisfies the demigods who are parts of that Supreme Personality, end quote. Srimad Bhagavatam 4.31.14. Whereas the Supreme Personality of Godhead is, when the Supreme Personality of Godhead is worshipped, all the demigods are satisfied. Text 31. After understanding the awkward position of Gajendra, who had offered his prayers, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, who lives everywhere, appeared with the demigods who were offering prayers to him. Carrying his disc and other weapons, he appeared there on the back of his carrier, Garuda, and with great speed, according to his desire. Thus he appeared before Gajendra. Purport. Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur specifically hints that since Gajendra was in such a difficult position and was praying for the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the demigods, who could have immediately gone to his rescue, hesitated to go there. Since they considered Gajendra's prayers to be directed towards the Lord, they felt offended, and this in itself was offensive. Consequently, when the Lord went there, they also went and offered prayers to the Lord so that their offense might be excused. Text 32. Gajendra had been forcibly captured by the crocodile in the water and was feeling acute pain, but when he saw that Narayan, wielding his disc, was coming in the sky on the back of Garuda, he immediately took a lotus flower in his trunk, and with great difficulty due to his painful condition, he uttered the following words, quote, O my Lord, Narayan, Master of the Universe, O Supreme Personality of Godhead, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, end quote. Purport. The king of the elephants was so very eager to see the Supreme Personality of Godhead that when he saw the Lord coming in the sky, with great pain and in a feeble voice, he offered respect to the Lord. A devotee does not consider a dangerous position to be dangerous, for in such a dangerous position he can fervently pray to the Lord in great ecstasy. Thus a devotee regards danger as a good opportunity. Tate nukumpam shushamika shamana. When a devotee is in great danger, he sees that danger to be great mercy of the Lord, because it is an opportunity to think of the Lord very sincerely and with undiverted attention. Tate nukumpam shusham mikshamano bunjana evat makritam bipekam. Srimad Bhagavatam 10.14.8. He does not accuse the Supreme Personality of Godhead for having let his devotee fall into such a dangerous condition. Rather, he considers that dangerous condition to be due to his past misdeeds and takes it as an opportunity to pray to the Lord and offer thanks for him for having been given such an opportunity. When a devotee lives in this way, his salvation, his going back home back to Godhead, is guaranteed. One can see this to be true from the example of Gajendra, who anxiously prayed to the Lord and thus received his immediate chance to return home. Back to Godhead. Text 33. Thereafter, seeing Gajendra in such an aggrieved position, the unborn Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, immediately got down from the back of Garuda by his causeless mercy and pulled the king of the elephants along with the crocodile out of the water. Then, in the presence of all the demigods who were looking on, the Lord severed the crocodile's mouth from its body with his disc. In this way, he saved Gajendra, the king of the elephants. Thus end the Bhaktivedanta purports of the 8th canto, 3rd chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled Gajendra's Prayers of Surrender.